Hey everybody, Dr. Brian Wickstrom here with River City Chiropractic, and we're in our series all about sciatica. And so in this video today, we're gonna be talking about some of the causes and what we do to help people diagnose and overcome sciatica when we're treating them. So first and foremost, as we've mentioned before, one of the key causes for sciatica is when people have degenerating or bulging spinal discs. And so when I'm evaluating a patient that comes in to see us, we don't like to just guess, we always test to find out where their spine's actually at. And so a key component with that is getting an x-ray. And so that way when we look at somebody's x-rays, we can see where their spine's at if they have the proper alignment position and curves that they need to have there. So the normal spine in the lower back, you wanna have a nice curve down here. It should be right around 35 degrees or so. And then from the front, the spine should be nice and straight, and you wanna have the hips balanced just like that. Another thing that we look at is you wanna have a nice thick disc spaces. So you gotta think about the discs of your spine are kind of like the wheels on your car. And so when your car is in good alignment, you can drive it around, the wheels are gonna last pretty long. If it's out of alignment, you keep driving it around, then the wheels wear down faster and everything else starts to just break down a lot quicker. And the exact same thing happens with your spine. And so when people start to lose these natural curves in the spine or the bones themselves get out of alignment, which again are called subluxations, that starts to cause the discs to break down and there's gonna be more stress and load on the spine itself if you don't have that curve there. And so then when you're reaching down to tie your shoe or you're lifting something in the garden or whatever, there's a lot more stress on the spine and that makes you more susceptible to end up bulging or herniating a disc in your lower back, which can ultimately lead to the sciatica. And so those are a couple key things that we look at. But in addition to that, how we're able to see specifically where your subluxations and misalignments are and where they're not is looking at actual motion of the spine. So we do some motion x-rays. And so when the spine's in alignment, and it's gonna be able to move properly. If it's out of alignment, then things get stuck. They're not able to move like they normally should with biomechanics. So this is an example of somebody bending to the left. And we also do the same thing, obviously going to the right, but we're limited on the space on the computer to show you. So what we look for here when somebody's bending to the one side or the other is the disc space in the lower back should normally kind of narrow down a little bit. And on the opposite side, it should open up. And this little white ring here, that should twist in the side that you're bending towards, okay? So if we don't see that proper motion in certain areas in the lower back, then that does indicate that you have some subluxations down there. And again, that puts you more at risk for disc problems or actually just irritating the nerves from things being out of alignment, which ultimately can lead to the sciatic problems that you're dealing with. And so that's one of the neat things that our patients experience as they go along through care in our office is that we also do post x-rays. So you're not just feeling better, you're able to see that your number of subluxations on your x-rays is actually going down because your spine's moving better, you're getting some of those natural curves back that you may have lost when you first started here, and that way we're really focusing on getting to the root of the sciatica, not just treating your symptoms and just to have it come back a few months or a year down the road. And so the key thing there is just getting a thorough exam, making sure getting some x-rays done. And those are some of the things that we do for our patients here in the office. So if you're out there dealing with sciatica, feel free to reach out to us. If you have any questions, concerns, we're here to help, and we will see you in the next video.